1980 was a year that really belongs in the 1970s. And during 1980, I was doing 1970s type stuff. Spinning at a disco, even though we were well into the disco sucks phase. It didn't suck. But that was the exception. Actually, on my dance floor, that song sounded refreshing and different because I was the only DJ doing this to it. Okay, it still sucks, but it sucks different. That's done by playing two records together with the second record one beat behind the first. Now, that kind of echo technique is something everybody did, but nobody thought of doing it just one beat behind. Most of the DJs would echo, but it would be either a two-beat or a four-beat delay. That was a one-beat delay. Worked. And I've got some stories I could tell about other DJs coming in and listening to me for ideas, but that's disco. But anyway, phones. In 1980, I was living in the Toco Hills Central Office Zone, actually just north of Buford Highway, and I was fortunate enough to once again have a step line in my apartment. Amazing. I actually got to have a step telephone line in 1980.
Hello there. Wanted to demonstrate a call from 634 to 325.
So once again, I enjoyed having number one step at home, but only until March of 1980. Here is what happened one night in March 1980. I turned on a tape recorder and put up a call to my line, and I just let it ring. This is the sound of my phone line while an incoming call is ringing on it. I recorded this because I had been tipped off that something was going to happen at this particular time, on this particular evening. Now, if you listen carefully, you'll hear a moment when the ring cycle kind of resets, and a strange burst of new dial tone comes on for just an instant. Here it is. Not sure what that was, but let's keep listening. Suddenly my phone line is dead. I have no talk battery. I don't seem to be connected to anything, in fact. You'll hear me on the pre-existing ESS line dialing into the step to see if I can even connect to it anymore. I'm not having any luck. Now, about 1 minute after that ring stopped, we got this click. I'm going to flash my hook.
Okay, the step is gone and my line is now dead.
It stayed that way for another 3 minutes, until finally...
Oh, what do you know? There we have it. What should my first call as an ESS customer be? Like I care? Jeez.
Good morning. A long-distance call brings family and friends closer together. The present temperature is 25 degrees. Central Standard Time. 12 hours, 17 minutes, 45 seconds.
The Weathercron is saying Central Time because Ellis Bryant has it configured to demonstrate it for a prospective customer in the Central Time Zone. But that is actually Eastern Time. The reason I know that is that 12:15 a.m. is the time when Southern Bell... Well, you know what they just did.
Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. And another one gone, and another one gone. Another one bites the dust. Hey, gotta get to two. Another one bites the dust.
Okay, they're not singing about electromechanical switches being replaced with ESS, but... they might as well be. That's the way the 1980s was. And the crossbar fives had already started being replaced in Atlanta. So now I was on ESS. But sometime between this and July, I did something very old school and analog. And that is, I built a homemade looparound for Atlanta callers to use to meet each other. A looparound is one of those arrangements where two lines connect together. And if there's someone on each number, they can talk to each other. The phone company invented these for testing purposes. Here's a 1981 recording of my talking to Ben on one of the telephone company looparounds in New York that has some real history. This looparound is in the Far Rockaway Central Office, which straddles the Queens-Nassau County border. 471 on the Queens side, 371 on the Nassau side. Ben and I both remember it well. In fact, it was the second looparound that I spoke to Bill on the day that I met him. The first one was in Levittown. But when Bill found out that Levittown was a two-message unit call for me, he said, oh goodness, well, let's switch over to Far Rockaway. With the telephone company looparounds, you would get this tone on one number, and it would go off and on like that, usually at least, until the other caller came on. Now, when you hear Ben's reaction to the timing on this looparound, please remember this is 1981, which for us is an epilogue year. So to call back on a looparound this late into the game is for us a trip down memory lane.
Hello.
I don't believe it.
This is amazing.
This has memories for me also.
This was the first... How long has it been?
Well, I can't believe it.
There's something so neat about this because... I don't know, there is some, it's more cool when it does this. You know what I mean?
You don't take it for granted.
I mean, it's not just, oh, that's a talking place. In the old days, I had no idea that there was any connection between 9900 and 9906, except that they both went tick-tick.
Yeah.
And I figured, I assumed that they were both controlled by the same timer. One went tick-tick silently, the other did with a tone, whoopee-doo. I was on that Hempstead End recording, and that was when Bill popped in. That's how I met Bill, you know, on that thing. And
he suggested getting on?
Yeah, he said 731-9906, not 371, but 731. And I said, what I said was, you can't call that just ticks, you know, I can't talk to you. What's that?
What could that do?
So when I called it, I assumed that he was a phone company employee who was... who was tapping in on it, and I said, hey, why don't you get in, why don't you go tap on 9932 so we won't have to talk on the tick, you know?
All right, that's clever.
Well, if this thing were shorting the line, you know.
Well, yeah, I suppose it's possible.
Why don't you hang up right after the tick and then come back in immediately, but hang up right after it comes back.
Why?
Because sometimes the tone comes back immediately, and on others it isn't until the that the thing realizes that you're gone.
Oh, yeah, right. Okay.
Okay, so after the next one, hang up and then just dial right back. This is so neat. I love this thing.
You know, I remember meeting one girl on here. Yeah.
Ben and I and others always liked the idea of a relay-operated device clicking away in a closet in your house somewhere, being a place of activity 24 hours a day. In fact, Mark Bernay did it. He had a homemade loop around. Unlike the phone company loops, Mark Bernay's homemade loop played the radio until the second caller reached it. And it would do that on either line, whichever one came in first. Because he was on number one crossbar, he had to flash the line at regular intervals as a way of detecting whether a caller had hung up or not. If someone had, a dial tone would come on, which his relays could detect. Just hanging up didn't click anything on crossbar one. Another feature was when one person hung up, the loop around would automatically disconnect the other as well. That was to keep it from being tied up by the same person all day. It worked pretty well.
KFRC got that band on a run. Son, 307 with Ed O'Brien. Here we go.
300.
Hi.
98.
Hi. 997. Hey, that's weird. Carol, you just came through first time around. Wow.
You did it big for $97.
For the love of money, cash countdown back on KFRC.
Hello?
Hi.
Who is this?
This is Bill.
Bill?
Hold on a sec. Hi.
Hello.
What?
Huh?
Hi.
What are you doing out here?
That was Dave, going by the pseudonym Bill, and Ben was there too. So Mark Bernay had already done this. I would have done it myself in the 70s had I had the opportunity. But now I did. It was 1980. There was time. I had a roommate, temporarily at least, who was willing to do it, Steve. And between us, we installed two phone lines. Meanwhile, I got some relays, installed them in a box, soldered them together after having designed the circuit, and voila, we had a homemade loop around. One of the things we had to do was to have a recording that played and said, charges to this number are not accepted. Otherwise, one person would be able to call one number and wait for someone else to call long distance through the operator, and then through the loop around say, sure, operator, I'll accept the charges. That was a real danger, so we had to have a recording. We were also concerned because at this particular time, telephone meeting lines were not an established thing. It was an unknown phenomenon. And we were concerned that if something negative happened when people met through our line, that we could be held liable. Nowadays, that sort of thing wouldn't be taken seriously. But at that time, it was just unknown, and we spoke to a lawyer, and he actually said that you should have your recording say, unauthorized use is expressly forbidden. I hated that idea because I don't like things that give a mixed message. But we put that on the recording, and we made the recording sound like just some guy at the phone company. Anyway, here's a call to our loop around.
Beep.
The first caller, whichever line he dialed, would get silence. Once the second caller had connected, the recording would be triggered. It was just a loop, and it would just play for a certain number of seconds.
Charges to this number are not accepted. This is recording. Unauthorized use of this type of facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is recording. Unauthorized use.
Hello?
Hello.
My hanging up on that caller caused him to be disconnected. That was a feature that we carried over from Mark Bernay, and because we were on number one ESS, which produces a clear battery drop the moment an incoming call disconnects, we did not have to flash the lines at regular intervals. No need to do that. The ESS did provide the necessary signal.
Charges to this number are not accepted. This is recording. Unauthorized use of this type of facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is recording.
Hello.
Oh, we got the right person this time. Terrific.
What's the activity like? It took me a few minutes to get through. Did you have a lot of people that you had to get rid of?
I had two or three of the same person. We're lucky it wasn't worse. But, what is this, Saturday night?
And I ain't got no body?
Yeah, well, that's the thing. On Saturday night, the activity is pretty slack at this time, because everybody has gone out.
Well, if you hung up, I'd get hung up on, but if you called in, it would pick up on me again, right?
Yeah, it would... Recording. If it hangs up on you, you're hung up on.
Oh, yeah, that's right. So there's no feed through of the ring in or something like that? Oh, forget it. No, it's ESS. Forget it.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Let me see. Why don't you hang up and let me hear, that operation. And then I'll call back again and try to keep the other one open for me, okay?
Let's see if I can. I'm going to try to arrange for you to get on first. It will have to be done artificially. And what I'm going to do is to make busy the...
Look, I don't care if I get someone... In other words, if I got someone else, well, I could do it again once, and then... But not twice. I don't want to spend too much money on this. But, I mean, if I do accidentally get someone else, okay. But the best thing to do is to just, give it a try.
Yeah, okay. Well, tell you what. This time you call 6997. There's really no difference between the two lines, but it'll be easier. And I'll try to let you get on first. Right now, the thing answers with silence. That's going to be changed to a tone.
What does?
The first person who calls in gets silence. And the recording comes on when both lines are on.
When the second person comes on, they both get the recording and you can talk through it?
The recording has the effect of an 8-ohm output across the line type.
Is there any room on the recording to try to scream through it?
Not really. It just keeps talking and talking and talking.
Okay, well anyway, so hang up on me and then I'll call 6997.
Alrighty, and okay, fine. Bye-bye.
Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this type of facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This type of facility is...
Hello?
Hello.
Oh, hi, how's it going?
Oh, pretty good. How's it going with you?
Away.
I'm sorry?
It's going away.
Oh, okay. I can't hear you all that well.
Oh.
Charges to this number are not accepted. This is recording. Unauthorized use of this type of facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is recording. Unauthorized use.
Hello?
Were you trying to talk during the recording?
No, I wasn't. Did you want me to?
I must have heard some background noise or something like that. Okay.
Success. You actually got on first. Terrific.
Actually, I'd also like to get some other calls. Can you manually trip me?
I tell you what I can do. I can go walk in there and flip the sit switch, which will enable you to stay on no matter how many people hang up on you. And furthermore, I can monitor the line and dump the people that come in without dumping you.
Okay, let's play a little bit with that. You can let me talk to various people and just keep running through them, okay?
Hold on a minute. Now I'm going to switch my tape recorder so that it will be monitoring the line. I've also...
What line are you going to monitor?
Monitoring 6996, the one you're not on. And there's very little difference, really. So the loading of the line will be the difference between this and this, which is very little. Okay, just...
What line will you record from?
6996.
All right, hold on a second.
All righty, now let me switch over.
And now, oh, the tape picks your carrier noise up very well now. Okay, I will, I've got to first go in the other room, then I can hang up. Just a sec.
Still there?
I'm here, what are you doing?
Yelling into the earpiece of the monitor phone. God, excuse me, there was a lot of stuff piled on top of the box that has the loop around in it, so bear with me a second. Alrighty, it's all yours. I'll be listening. In fact, why don't you say the word dump when you want me to do so?
That click was my line that called into the loop, timing back to dial tone, 10 seconds after it was hung up on.
Okay, I'll say something like that.
All right.
These are typical 1A ESS idle line noises, not in the daytime.
Short is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is
Stone Reception Squad, can I help you?
It's me. We're not getting too many calls. There should be a call in less than a minute normally, but I figured I'd demonstrate the difference between touch toning during the recording and touch toning after the recording.
Yeah, it came through.
Yeah, it sounded very, if you're local to it, it sounds very much like the typical local vacant code type filtering.
Dump this guy.
Oh, I'll dump the guy.
Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden.
Test facility, can I help you?
Hello. Hello?
Yes, this is the test facility. Can I help you?
What test facility?
Didn't you listen to the recording?
Yes, I did.
Didn't it mention a test facility?
No.
Call back again right now and you'll hear it. Dump the guy.
Number not accepted. This test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden.
Test facility.
Hello?
Yes, can I help you?
Yeah, what are you doing?
Testing the test facility.
Huh?
I said I'm testing the test facility.
Oh.
We'll test the dump feature now.
What?
I said, here's the dump feature.
Sorry that Ben and I think being a jackass is a way of being cool. Anyway, we've hung up on the caller, but there is a click that is made on our line when the caller finally disconnects. We can tell that the caller is calling from number 5 crossbar, because 20 seconds after he is hung up on, There, that was his call leaving the line. Of course, had he hung up his phone, it would have happened sooner.
This test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted.
Hello?
Yes, did you hear the recording?
Yeah.
This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This test facility is expressly forbidden.
Hi!
Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is
Yes, what number are you dialing?
I'm calling 326996.
Well, I'm afraid you have reached that number, but it's hung up on you.
Oh, don't make me do that. I always wanted to talk to you. If you don't, I'll have to go talk to my rat named Ben.
That does it. I'm hanging up.
This is forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number...
222, who the heck are you?
Hello?
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 Who is this?
Ben.
Ben? How are you?
Alrighty, where am I calling from?
Huh?
Where am I calling from?
Where are you calling from?
Is there an echo on this line?
You're a comedian.
Or a comedian, as some people who don't know English say. I also have one other ability.
And what is that?
This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is
Doorbell theme squad.
Doorbell theme squad, huh?
Let me see how the tape's coming out.
All right.
You can leave yours running.
Okay. Excuse me.
What is that?
Yep.
Recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is
Doorbell theme squad.
Doorbell theme squad,
Let me see how the tape's coming out.
Alright.
You can leave yours running.
Okay. Excuse me. Excuse me. Well, excuse you, too.
Yeah, a little AVC clipping when I talk loudly, but it's alright. Anyway, this is a lot of fun. Some of those calls are very good.
I guess what I should do is go flip the sit switch back to normal so that when I hang up, you will really be disconnected.
Yeah, in other words, you'll release the set switch with the next person there.
Right, I'm going to hang up now, and then I'm going to throw the sit switch, so the next person that comes in and then hangs up will disconnect you.
Okay.
I'll let somebody else do it, and if they don't come in time, I'll do it. All right? Talk to you later.
This test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden.
Operator, what number are you dialing?
320-6996.
Oh, I'm sorry. You reached the wrong number. Would you try again?
Okay.
That time, Ben was hung up on. But his call will stay on the line for another 20 seconds. When Ben actually gets disconnected, it'll be slightly after this next call comes in. You won't hear anything on the line.
The recording hadn't went yet.
In the the last few minutes, we heard Ben staying on one of the lines thanks to our sit switch. That was a feature built into the Looparound, where if Steve or I, or in this case Ben, wanted to stay on the line and not be affected by the normal cutoff feature, we would throw this little switch and then you could stay there and other people could hang up on you and you could just sit there and get the next call. Of course, what we were mainly doing is having me disconnect the other party. The Looparound knew that, but it didn't disconnect Ben. So now here is a little more with the recorder on 6996. It's just me and whoever calls in, no sit switch.
Hello, now I'm on 6.
Charges to this number are not accepted. This is recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is recording.
Hello?
Hello.
How are you doing?
Pretty good. How are you?
Oh, I'm sneaking by. What you up to?
Right now, I'm on 6996, and you're on 6997.
That's true.
I rang in first, and I also want to get it the other way around, so this time I'm going to ring in on 7 first.
As use of this test facility is expressly forbidden.
Okay, now I'm on 7.
This number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized.
As I started to say, now I'm on 7, and you're on 6, and I rang in first.
Facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not
Hello?
Hello?
Hello? I don't hear you too good.
Hey, who's this?
Say what?
What's your name?
My name's Jack. What's yours?
Diane.
Who?
Diane.
Diane, huh?
Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden.
Hello? There was a guy on 6996, and somebody was talking to him, but they hung up on him.
Yeah,
but he didn't hang up his phone. So even though he's off the loop, the line stays busy for a little while after he gets hung up on. Uh-huh. So if you dialed 7, it would ring into nobody, and if you dialed 6, it was busy.
What are you up to this evening?
Probably about half of the demonstration.
Half of what?
Yeah, that's probably what I'm up to.
Half of what?
The demonstration. There'll be a little more and then I'll be through with it. See, and so I'm halfway. You calling from 37?
Huh?
You calling from 37?
37 what?
37 something.
Mm.
I hear that kind of noise on the line, that's why I wonder.
Yeah,
why? I was just...
What happened there is not clear. I do know that I got a call waiting deep, but normally that would produce a battery interruption on the Looparound, causing it to hang up on both people. Evidently that didn't happen, because the guy was saying hello for more than 10 seconds after the click. And that's not possible to do on ESS, because ESS has that anti-black box feature, so that when you're hung up on, you can't be heard saying hello. Unless you're in the same office, but then that's only for 10 seconds and he lasted longer than that. So I'm really at a loss to explain how he was able to stay on saying hello like that.
Charges to this number are not accepted.
Hello there. On that last call, I was disconnected by a call waiting beep on my line.
Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted.
Hello?
Hello.
What's up, Ted? On that last call, I was disconnected by a call waiting beep on my line.
Do what?
This thing senses disconnect by a battery drop on the line. Now, if you are in the 3-2 office and you get a call waiting beep, that will cause a battery drop on both parties' lines. And again, the loop around hangs up on you. So, you have a hard time with custom calling features if you're in 3-2 using this thing.
I think I'd better explain why I'm behaving in this particular strange way. No, I don't actually think that the guy understands what I'm saying. I'm just being a jackass. This is a running joke that Ben began in, I think, 1974, maybe 1975. With the tape running, he was explaining something to the tape recorder. At some point during his demonstration, an intercept operator came on the line and said, "What number are you calling?" But in the spirit of being a smartass, Ben decided to pretend he didn't hear her and go right on talking with her sitting there. At some point, his discussion required him to say what date or what day it was, and so he stopped and said, "Operator, what day is it?" And she told him. He then went right back to his technical discussion for the tape recorder, pretending that the operator wasn't there again. So that running joke, actually running way of being a jackass, is what's going on here.
Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden.
Hello?
Oh, by the way, the tones you heard there were the sound not of me dialing it, but of him dialing it. See, you were trying to get two lines on.
Trying to do what?
Trying to get two lines on. You rang in on 6996, mm-hmm. And then you tried with your other phone to get in on 6997. But I got in just before you did, see? So you got it busy and I got in.
Do you work for the phone company?
No.
You don't?
No.
I was just curious.
That's understandable.
You know, there is no circumstance nowadays under which I would behave this way. People who do not know everything about what's going on are not idiots to be disrespected. They're just unaware of what's going on. And back in 1980, I thought I was so clever. I could hear his touch tones. I know he's calling from a step. And I'm just going to have a great thrill dialing my last digit at the exact second to stop him from getting into the line again.
Not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility.
I tell you, I keep beating you to it every time. Jeez, isn't that irritating?
Okay, that's enough. Now, before we go, there's one more perspective from which to be a jackass. I mean, to record the loop around.
So, I'm going to put the microphone into the box with the loop, and you will hear the sound of the relays as calls come in and hang up, and may even hear the cassette machine motor running. So here it is.
Have fun in there.
objections to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This test facility is expressly...
Hello. How's it going? Pretty good. Now I'm on 6 and you're on 7.
Uh-huh.
Now I'm on 6 and you're on 7 and I'm going to hang up. I'm on 7 waiting now.
Charges to this number are not accepted. This is recorded. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is recorded.
Okay, this time I'm on 7 and you're on 6. And I'm going to hang up. Okay, I'm on 7 right now. And I'm going to hang up and call back in again. Before someone rings in. I'm on 7 again. I'm going to let someone ring in, but as soon as they ring in, I'm going to hang up. Ah, geez. I'm going
to... This test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges... Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording. Unauthorized use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is a recording.
Yeah, that time you rang in on 7 right after I hung up on 6, and then I called back on 6. Why don't you hang up this time?
Why?
Well, it's boring without when I hang up all the time. We should have it when you hang up. You know, it creates more variety.
What do you mean?
Ah, forget it. Okay, I'm on 7, waiting for someone to come in on 6.
Use of this test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This test facility is expressly forbidden. Charges to this number are not accepted. This is recorded.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, this is the exact opposite of before. I'm on 7 and you're on 6. Now this time, let's see, this time you're going to hang up, except not with your switch hook, I'll do it by shorting your line.
Shortly after these recordings were made, I moved out. Steve stayed there until early 1982. My next telephone service was in Decatur, in the 37 ESS, although during the time these recordings were made, 37 was still a step. In fact, that guy who I kept preventing from grabbing the line and getting rid of me, he was calling from the 37 step. You could actually hear his wire connection and some step crosstalk on at least two occasions. This loop around ran until I think 1982, when Steve moved to the Norcross area and decided not to take the loop with him. So there was no loop around for a while during 83, but 1984 saw something so much better than this that it was just incredible. I mean, talk about relays clicking in your closet, and in Southern Bell's closet. What am I saying? Look, this loop around could only handle one conversation, and it took two telephone lines to do that. It was active pretty much 24 hours a day, but at most, it had one conversation going at a time. The device that I invented in 1984, however, required only one telephone line, and it created 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 conversations at once, at times, just using that one phone line. How was that possible? Two words. Call transfer. More about that in the final program of the early 80s series, which will be out before the series is finished. Well, that's pretty much it for this segment. I will leave you with the sounds of the relays recorded without line monitor. The Cutover segment is from March 1980, the New York Looparound segment is from 1981, the Mark Burnet loop is a composite from the mid-70s, and the recordings of My Looparound are from July 1980. The behavior of the recorded announcement on My Looparound is inconsistent in this program due to calls having been edited out.